Well, the unrest in Kashmir over the death of Hizbul Commander Burhan Wani continues to escalate as Pakistan observed a Black Day. Separatists in the valley expressed solidarity with Islamabad. They, in fact, have also asked people to hoist black flags over their houses and also observe a complete blackout between 8:30 and 9 at night today.
Curfew remains in force in all 10 districts in Kashmir Valley. But thankfully, after 13 days of unrest, there are no signs of deadly clashes witnessed after Hizbul terrorist Burhan Wani's death. But pro-Pakistan separatists raised black flags to show solidarity with PAK's call to observe a Black Day.
Curfews and restrictions are being imposed almost all across Kashmir. The separatist parties have given out calls of observing Black Day. A joint statement was sent across by Mirwais Umar Farooq, Sayyid Ali Shah Gilani and leaders like Yasin Malik.
Pakistan meanwhile continued to play Valley's villain, raising the Kashmir issue with top UN official claiming rights violations. Pakistani Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif rejected Kashmir being India's internal matter. Promising to back Kashmiri cause, Nawaz said that Pakistan will hold global seminars to expose India. PAK's terror proxies meanwhile continued to stoke fire. Jaish founder Masood Azhar linking Pathankot attack to Kashmir unrest. 2611 plotter Hafiz Saeed threatened to launch a march to Kashmir and claimed that slain Burhan Wani called him days before his death.
Shahadat se chand din pehle mujhse phone par kaha ke meri zindagi ki khwahish thi ke main aapse baat kar lu, khwahish puri hogi, ab main sirf shahadat ka muntazir hoon. Aaj hum apne Kashmiri bhaiyon ko ye aitmaad dilana chahte hain कि अगर आप मैदान में हैं तो इंशाल्लाह हम आपके भाई हम भी मैदान में हैं. कश्मीर की आजादी को कोई नहीं रोक सकता.
India has cited Hafiz Saeed's statement as proof that Pakistan is fomenting trouble in the Kashmir Valley. With Shujal Haq in Srinagar, Bureau Report, India Today.
Well, it is the most explicit call to war by Parliament attack mastermind Maulana Masood Azhar after 2611 mastermind Hafiz Saeed and Sayyid Salahuddin, who is the head of the United Jihad Council. Now, Azhar has joined the Kashmir chorus. The Jaish-e-Mohammed chief, who is supposedly under protective custody, has even linked the Kashmir unrest to the Pathankot attacks and is clearly helping Pakistani government hell-bent on trying to internationalize the Kashmir issue. India Today is in position. is in possession of this audio tape that has been released by the Jaish.
Ek baat pakki hai, inshallah Kashmir ne zarur azad hona hai. Ye mubarak tahreek apne un tamam imtihanat se guzar chuki hai jo kisi bhi tahreek ko khatam karne ke liye kafi hote hain. Is tahreek ki god mein maloom nahi kitne afzal guru, kitne ghazi baba, kitne sajjad afghani aur kitne burhan wani pal rahe hain. बेरोजगारी और जहालत की वजह से तो लोग चोर बनते हैं, डाकू बनते हैं, मिरासी और फनकार बनते हैं, शोबीज और बेहयाई के पेशों में जाते हैं, सियासतदानों के कन टुट्टे बदमाश और वडेरों, जागीरदारों, चौधरियों और खानों के गुलाम बनते हैं. जिहाद में तो इल्म वाले आते हैं, जिहाद में दर्द दिल वाले उतरते हैं जो अपनी ज़ात के खोल में कैद नहीं होते बल्कि इस्लाम और मुसलमानों का सोचते हैं. एक बार किसी मौसर हस्ती ने मुझे कहा, मौलाना अब तो जिहाद छोड़ो, कोई इल्मी काम करो, तुम्हारे अंदर इल्मी इस्तेदाद मौजूद है. बंदा ने उनसे अर्ज़ किया, जनाबे वाला, जिहाद छोड़ते हुए शर्म आती है. फिर ये हुआ कि हम जो चंद अफराद जिहाद के लिए खड़े हुए तो हमारे कई रुफका शहीद हो गए, वो आगे निकल गए. उनके जाने के बाद हम पीछे हट जाएँ और रास्ता बदल लें तो बहुत शर्म आती है, बहुत शर्म. फिर 9/11 और बुश मुशर्रफ वाजपेयी इत्तेहाद ने जिहाद कश्मीर पर फैसला कुन वार किया. तहरीक कश्मीर का जुनून कदरे कमज़ोर हुआ और मुजाहिदीन के रास्ते बंद. मगर जिहाद तो अल्लाह ताला का हुक्म है, वही जिहाद की तौफीक देता है और वही जिहाद को चलाता है. जिहाद ना हुकूमतों का मोहताज है और ना ही एजेंसियों का. अल्लाह ताला जब चाहता है अपने दुश्मनों और मुनकिरों को भी जिहाद और मुजाहिदीन की खिदमत पर मजबूर फरमा देता है. अब एक बार फिर जिहाद कश्मीर के शोले लपके हैं. पठानकोट में मुजाहिदीन ने एक बड़ा हमला करके अहले कश्मीर के हौसले बुलंद कर दिए और अब बाज मुजाहिदीन किराम की शहादत ने पूरी कश्मीरी कौम को खड़ा कर दिया है। इस मौके पर हमारा फ़र्ज बनता है कि हम हर तरह से कश्मीरी मुसलमानों की मदद करें और जिहाद कश्मीर के झंडे और आलम को हरगिज़ हरगिज़ ना गिरने दें। ए मुसलमान भाइयों, अगर हम जिंदा हुए और जिहाद कश्मीर का झंडा गिर गया और हमारी ज़िंदगी में मुशरिकों ने फतह का जश्न मनाया, तो सोचो हमारी ज़िंदगी और हमारी जवानी किस काम की।
All right, let me first go across to Tariq P. Zada, defense analyst who's joining us on the phone line from Pakistan. Now, my colleague Gaurav Sawant is also live with us from the newsroom. But Mr. P. Zada, I want to ask you first, how are you then going to deny the allegations that Pakistan and the terror organizations that it shelters are actively involved in fueling unrest in Kashmir when you have Maulana Masood Azhar admitting it on tape?
Well, you know, the problem in India is that they look at Kashmir as their internal issue. And the issue is this in Pakistan, that Kashmir is an issue that remains disputed under
Mr.
the Pizada, resolution.
If you don't mind, I would rather not be lectured on what the problem with India is. Can you please just tell me how
you are going to deny the fact
that Pakistan is involved in fueling unrest in Kashmir when you have Maulana Masood Azhar, incidentally the Pathankot terror attack mastermind, admitting that he is doing it. He is calling for jihad in Kashmir.
You are fueling the so-called unrest in Kashmir. I got your question. Here's the answer. According to, in the eyes of every single Pakistani, including Mr. Masood Azhar, whether he's a terrorist or not, every single Pakistani believes that there is a freedom movement that is going on in the Indian occupied Kashmir, and it must be supported by every single Pakistani with all the means available to Pakistan and to every Pakistani.
All right, so basically, you are admitting that yes, your government is sponsoring these activities in Kashmir, right?
Well, maybe 220 million Pakistanis are committing acts of terror, but that's an act of freedom under the in the eyes of the people of Pakistan.
No, it doesn't matter what it is in your eyes. The fact is, it is encouraging terrorism, and you're saying that yes, it is being done actively by Pakistan.
No,
thank you very much for joining us.
It is terrorism.
Yes, of course it is terrorism. And you are sponsoring terrorism.
It is freedom movement.
And you are sponsoring the likes of Maulana Masood Azhar as well, who incidentally in the dossier given by our national security advisor is a terrorist responsible for masterminding the attack on our Air Force base in Pathankot. So you are sheltering a terrorist, allowing him to release these statements.
No, we are not sheltering a terrorist.
And actively backing him as he calls for jihad in Kashmir. Thank you very much for that explicit confession on television. Thank you, Mr. P. Zada, for joining us. Let me go across to my colleague, Gaurav Sawant. Gaurav, again, we keep coming back to the question that here you have someone who has been named in a dossier by India as responsible for a terror attack as recently as the 2nd of January in Pathankot. He releases this statement, again trying to foment terror and foment trouble in Kashmir. How are we going to talk to Pakistan? How are we going to engage with Pakistan when this continues to happen?
You know, that is something that Prime Minister Narendra Modi will need to answer. But one thing is very clear. The three fountainheads of terror in India, Maulana Masood Azhar, the Maulana of terror, he's clearly saying that they are encouraging jihad in Jammu and Kashmir and that he actively participated in it. You cannot get a clearer confession than this, that he's involved in jihad in Jammu and Kashmir or terrorism in Jammu and Kashmir. He's saying it himself. And he's supposed to be in custody in Pakistan, but that's how openly he's roaming around. Second, this so-called Karwai Kashmir, the Hafiz Mohammed Saeed's entire bandwagon is marching from Lahore to Islamabad. Again, he's a terror mastermind. Again, he's one man who's a designated global terrorist, but absolutely no action against him by the Pakistani government. And third is Syed Salahuddin, the man who was encouraging terrorists like Burhan Wani. So all these people who claim that Burhan Wani was some kind of a Twitter-savvy youngster who was encouraging people for some kind of a freedom struggle, they too completely stand exposed, because it's clear that Burhan Wani was just a pawn and these big terror masterminds in Pakistan were running him as they continue to form in trouble in Jammu and Kashmir, Padmaja.
And it doesn't just stop there, Gaurav, because it's not just using Burhan Wani like a pawn, but also trying to capitalize on his subsequent killing by the Indian Security Forces, the SOG operation, trying to capitalize on that and foment trouble. That is also now clearly outlined, not just through the confessions that the likes of Maulana Masood Azhar have made, but also from the pattern that has emerged, how the social media activity, criticizing the encounter, talking about Azadi, all of that is being coordinated.
Spot on. In fact, the government prevailed on Twitter, got Hafiz Saeed's Twitter account deleted. But he realizes how important it is to have access to social media. He had a new Twitter account created and then again started fueling this unrest in Jammu and Kashmir. And whatever instructions come from across the border in Pakistan, from Hafiz Mohammed Saeed or Sayyid Salahuddin or Masood Azhar, you have the separatists in Jammu and Kashmir, in Srinagar Valley. They follow their command hook, line and sinker. They follow it to the T. And this goes on to show that all these claims about disgruntled youth wanting to rise against all of them are clearly taking instructions from either these separatists or their masters across the border.
All right, Gaurav, stay with me. We also have Shafkat Saeed with us on the phone line. Now, Mr. Shafkat Saeed, you have someone who was hailed by the terror masterminds who are being sheltered in your country as some sort of a freedom fighter. And now you're trying to capitalize on his death. You have Maulana Masood Azhar trying to prop up Burhan Wani and asking for jihad in his name. Isn't this an active confession of how terror is being encouraged from the soil of your country?
No, don't blame the country. It is this unresolved issue of Kashmir which has resulted in birth of these unwanted elements on both sides of the border. I feel if the problem of Kashmir is resolved, these nonsense would finish. The people who terrorize the population of subcontinent, you curse them, we curse them, and we go into blame game, and this unrest prevails on both sides of the border, and we have been in uneasy relationship since 70 years. We have fought wars on this. Numerous people have died. I think this must end. And this would only end if Kashmir problem is resolved.
People who are responsible for terror activities in India were not being sponsored and encouraged and sheltered by Pakistan and being allowed to issue such inflammatory statements like what Maulana Masood Azhar has done today. He incidentally is not even supposed to be allowed to give out all of these statements. Thanks very much, Lieutenant Colonel Shafkat Saeed, for joining us.